So, as you recall, we have that change in enthalpy, entropy is that S2 minus S1. This is Q from 1 to 2 over T. Its unit is entropy. The unit is in kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. Okay. So let's first derive the thermal efficiency, since the entropy is a continuation in the second law of thermodynamics. So we will relate the thermal efficiency based on our entropy. So when you recall the Carnot cycle, when you have high temperature and low temperature reservoir, so as you draw the TS diagram here, we'll use now the entropy. This is T, and this is entropy, temperature versus entropy diagram. So here we have that one. This is our TL, and this is our TH here. Okay, so considering reversible processes, so from 0.1 to 2, that is isothermal process. From 2 to 3, this is isentropic. From 3 to 4, that is isothermal. And from 4 to 1, that is isentropic. Okay? So, so for reversible adiabatic process, we have isentropic process or constant entropy. Okay, so we're in your delta S is Q over T. This is reversible. This is equal to 0. Meaning your S, this change, this is equal to 0. Okay, meaning you have a constant entropy. Okay, here you have this QH and QL. QL here. Okay. So now we have the thermal efficiency. This is in terms of Q, this is Q H minus QL over QH, right? So based on the TS diagram, we know that QH, this is TH S2 minus S1, right? And QL, this is TL times the quantity S3 minus S4. Okay, so we substitute here value of QH and QL. This is TH times S2 minus S1. QL is TL TL S3 minus S4. All over TH S2 minus S1. Okay. S2 minus S1. So, as you can see in the figure here, you have this one, this value here, the change in entropy is constant. We have this asymptotic process. So this quantity is 2 minus S1 is equal to S3 minus S4. Okay, so hence you can write since S2 minus S1 is equals equivalent to S3 minus S4, so we can, by factoring, we can cancel out this one here, since this is equal, the quantity of the change of entropy is equal, so there remains the thermal efficiency as in terms of temperature. In terms of temperature, this is at TH minus TL over TH right. So when you recall, we derived the thermal efficiency in the second law of thermodynamics, right? So here we use the law of entropy, or the entropy as we're going to derive the thermal efficiency. So you can compare that is equal. Okay. So considering reversible processes, because we consider the Carnot as the highest efficiency that a machine can be attained. Okay. So also for my computing, also the to call this the COP for a heat pump and a refrigerator, still considering the reverse Carnot process. So the CP of the refrigerator, this is equivalent to QL over QH minus QL. This is TL over TH minus TL. And the COP of the heat pump, this is QH over QL. And this is equivalent to TH over TH this is QH minus QL. Okay, this is TH minus TL. Okay, so we have the same result here using the entropy and the second law of thermodynamics. Okay, so considering for a pure substance, since the entropy is also a property for a pure substance, so here I drew its TS diagram here. So we have that one. This is our critical point. We have the mixture of liquid and vapor here. This one, this is the mixture of liquid and vapor. So this is pressure is constant. So we have, this is our SF, meaning liquid, entropy of our saturated gas and our saturated vapor and saturated liquid. And this one is the mixture of liquid and vapor. Okay, so if you have here, we have this one. This is a mixture of liquid and vapor. Have this liquid plus vapor. Okay. And also, its mass is equivalent to mf. Meaning the mass of the liquid and the mass of the vapor. We have the... we have the Sg, the entropy of the gas of the vapor, and the, which is equivalent to the mass of the vapor times this specific entropy. And the SF is the mass of the liquid times the specific entropy of your saturated liquid. So again, the same equation, you have the same equation, we have that S is SF plus SG. Right, so we have M S equals to M F SF plus MG SG. So we have this entropy, this is MF SF over M plus MG SG over M, where M is our total mass. M is our total mass. So simplifying this one, you have this M minus MG, this is over M, SF plus MG over M SG. Okay, so what do we have here? 1 minus MG over M, that is MG over M, we know from our thermo 1, that is the quality X. Okay, so this is 1 minus X. SF, right? SF plus X SG. So therefore we have here S, we have SF plus X X times SG minus SF, or we have this entropy SF plus X SFG. You're in your SFG is the difference of your entropy saturated vapor minus entropy saturated liquid. Okay, so you have that entropy as a property. Recall also, this is the same as the enthalpy HF plus X HFG. And you have internal energy, specific internal energy UF plus X U F G, and we have this specific volume, we have V F plus X V V F G. X V F G, right? Okay, so that is for applied for a pure substance. Okay, so let's continue. That is very easy, huh? So here we have this relation TD S equals to DU plus P DV. Okay, and this is based on our based on the first law. We have Q. We have Q. This is delta U plus work, no? This is delta U plus work. So we have, since Q is the TdS, and we have the DU and work, we have that PdV. Also, we can write that T DS, we have here DH minus V DP. Okay, so the exact differential of Q, this is equivalent to DU plus an exact differential of W. As you recall in our first law, so we have DS here. This is Q over T. This is reversible. And this Q is an exact differential W. This is PdV. Okay, so therefore we have this relation TdS. TdS is TdS is DU This is DU plus PdV. This is DU plus PdV. Okay, no. So we also in terms of H or your enthalpy, this is U plus P V, right? So by differentiation, we have DH equals DU. This is DU plus P DV plus V DP. Okay, and we have DH here. We have DH minus VDP. This is DU plus PdV. Okay, so we have TdS is DH minus V D P. Okay, we have these two relations, and also we have the TDS. We have here DH minus VDP. Okay. So now we go to the ideal gas. We have this for ideal gases. We will determine what is the entropy for an ideal gas. So we have this relation TdS. This is du plus PdV. PdV. Okay, so we have du is CV O dt, and we have PV is equivalent to RT, this in terms of mass. So ds here, we have our ds, this is equivalent to CV O. This is d d. This is dt over t. Plus r. This is t. Over t dv over v. So therefore, our ds is from point 1 to 2, we have ds2 minus, we have s1. This is what? Since you can take this one, so this is the integral of take the integral here, you have the integral of C V O, C V O dt over t plus r ln r ln of V2 over V1. So since CVO, this is constant, right? That is a constant. So you can write this one, S2 minus S1. This is CVO. Ln T2 over T1, this is plus R Ln of V2, V2 over V1. Okay. So we have this one here. This is for ideal gas. Okay. Okay. So based on so also for this relation, if you have T ds equals dh. You have dh minus VdP, right? So dh here, our dh, so recall in our term 1, this is at constant pressure, we have that one, dt, and V is R T over P. Okay, so we have our DS here. We have CPO DT over T minus R T DP over P. So we have, by taking the derivative, we have S2 minus S1, considering initial and final state, you have 2 points. So this is the integral of from 1 to 2, integral of CPO dt over t. Okay, minus R, this is R, but R ln P2 over R ln RLN P2 over P1. Okay, so if we have constant pressure here, it's constant, so we have S2 minus S1, we have CPO CPO ln ln T2 over T1 minus R ln of P2 over P1. Okay. So this is for if the CPO is constant. So by knowing the mass of our ideal gas, so we have here this S2, this capital S2 minus S1. This is mass times this small letter S2 minus S1. Okay. Also, we have here this an exact differential of W is equal to P dV. Okay, so we have the TdS is dU. This is dU plus P dV. So if this is small, okay, this is a small value, it can be negligible. So we have this DS, we have this DS, this is approximately equal to D over T, right? And we have here C, have the C dt dt over t. Okay, so also you have S2 minus S1. This is C ln T2 over T1. Well, C is your this C is the specific heat of solid or liquid. Specific heat of liquid or solid. Okay, can you follow? Yes, can you follow? Okay. So let's proceed. So you have that for an ideal gas, for a pure substance. And we derived its relation, the thermal efficiency and the COP of the refrigerator and the heat pump. Now we will determine the entropy change during an irreversible process. Entropy change of or entropy change during an irreversible process. Entropy change during an irreversible process. So we have this cyclic integral. This is an exact potential of Q over T. This is lesser than or equal to zero. Okay. So example, we have that one here. We have this point two, point one to point two. Okay, considering this path here as our A, this is reversible, and this path B is also reversible. And we have this path C here is reversible also. So we have we have these three paths here. We have that A, B, and C. Which is reversible. Okay. So process A to B, considering that is reversible process, you have this integral one A to 2A Yeah, this one. Q over T plus this integral to B 2B to 1B. Okay, so in exact principle of Q with respect to T is equal to 0, since you consider the process to be irreversible. So you consider that as that is reversible. So from process A to C, have the process A to C, we have this integral from 1A to 2A, 1A 2A, we have an exact differential of Q with respect to T plus this integral 2C to 1C, this 2C, you have 2C here, 2C to 1C, this is Q over T. This is lesser than or equal to 0. Or this is less than or equal to 0. So we relate this to process. So by subtracting, this quantity here will be taken out. So the remaining is here, the integral of 2b. This is 2b integral of 2b to 1b. We have here Q over T. This is greater than the integral of 2C to 1C. This is exact differential of Q over T. So for reversible process, we have D as Q over T. This is reversible. So the delta S, considering the path V here, this is equivalent to D S, considering our path C. Okay. Okay. So DS is greater than or equal to respect to T. So this equal sign here refers to the reversible process, and this greater than is our irreversible. Okay. So for entropy, if that is greater than, that is irreversible. Meaning that is the actual process. Reversible is the idea. So right. So okay. I have no questions. Can you follow? So if there's none, we will continue. Okay. So we have that lost work for irreversible process. We have that lost work. That is L. This is lost work. So considering here we have a piston. Okay. This is the gas. Okay. So Q. Based on our first law, we have du plus this w. Okay, so q is du plus p dv, and here w is P dv, right? Okay, this is W. Okay, so our lost work is that to be zero. Okay, so if you have for the free expansion here, we have the gas here, we have that membrane, this is our membrane. So if you remove the membrane, considering here as the side is empty, so you remove that membrane, you have that free expansion. So for free expansion we have the inexact W is equal to zero. Okay, so what do we have is Q, the inexact differential of Q equivalent to du. Okay, so you studied about the in your math, you have this one dimension and two dimension, you have this x and y. So for real numbers, for example, you have that x, you have that from negative infinity to positive infinity, right? So here we will consider this line here, this is the irreversible and this is the reversible process. In between this process, there is always a varying degree of irreversibility because of its lost work. And we discussed that earlier, or in our previous meeting, the causes, or what are the causes of the process to be irreversible, example for the friction, for expansion, the heat, the temperature difference, and so on. So in between this process here, from irreversible to reversible, there's always a degree of irreversibility. Okay, in between this process, There is always. There's always a varying meaning changing chain. It varies, it depends on the depends on the condition, degree of irreversibility. Okay. So we have that one. We have DS that is greater than or equal to Q over T. Okay. So we have this PdV equivalent to W plus your lost torque, right? This is your actual here. This is your actual torque, and you have that lost torque. So using the relation, you have this the relation TDS. This is du plus p d v, right? So here we have TDS du plus w plus your lost work. Okay. So since we know this du plus this actual differential to w to be this one, that is q, right? So we can write this TDS. This is q plus your lost work. Lost torque. Okay, so you can write your DS. This is Q over T plus your lost torque over T. Okay. This is your change of entropy. This is change in entropy during an irreversible process. So when the process is not reversible, there's always lost work. There are losses. Okay? So this is the equation. Alright? Any questions so far? Hello? Again? Hello? Napa mo niya? Okay. None so far, okay. Okay, kung wala, then let's proceed. So, considering a system, you know what is what a system is. System is. We have that system. We have this. You have your work, and you have system. Considering you have the temperature, you have Q, and you have the surrounding. We have that TO. If the temperature of our system is greater than TO, we have here DS. You have two conditions now. If that is T is greater than TO, and your TO is greater than T. Okay. So we have, again, we have DS, this is greater than or equal to Q over T. Here, the temperature, the DS of your surrounding, so you have your surrounding, it is negative of Q over TO. Okay. So we have the DS, the net. This is at delta S of your system plus the delta S of your surrounding. Delta S of your surrounding. Okay. So this is greater than or equal to negative Q negative Q over T plus this differential of Q over T O. Okay, so this is greater than or equal. We factor out the cube, so we have negative 1 over T. We have 1 over T plus 1 over T O. Okay, this is your D S net. And again, your D S net is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, it is greater than or equal to 0. Okay. So the principle of the increase in entropy. Principle of the increase in entropy. So we'll consider the system plus surrounding. So we have the system. Plus your surrounding. Or this is your isolated system. Okay, so the delta S of your isolated system this is also greater than or equal to zero. Okay. Okay. So we have this term red. Or this is the dead state here. This is not red. Dead state. There is no energy. So so we can define now the other definition of thermodynamics. Okay, now. This is what energy plus entropy, energy and entropy. So energy just refers to your first law, and entropy this is refers to your second law. Okay, so your first law deals only with the quantity of energy. The entropy deals in the quality of energy. Okay, so that's why you need to determine this, its efficiency, because we are more concerned on the quality. Okay, so hence, therefore, the entropy is S is the creation of this or this orderliness into a more ordered form. Okay. This entropy S here, creation of disorderliness into a more ordered form. Okay. Okay, so you have any question in mind? If there is none, we'll continue. We determine the we'll consider four gases. We'll consider gases here. We have four gases. We have this reversible adiabatic process. This is isentropic. So, if that is isentropic, that means dS is zero. Or, considering that it is a gas, your PV decay is constant. Your K is CpO over CvO. Your R, value of your R for gases, that is CpO minus CvO. We derive this one sa itong term 1, no? So reversible, that is reversible polytropic process. For a reversible polytropic process, your delta S is not equal to zero. Reversible isothermal your delta S is also not equal to zero. Okay. Okay. Now, pleiotropic, considering the pleiotropic process, you have the PV to the N. For gases, you have PV to the N is constant. And you have this relation, T. You have this in your thermal one, no? TV to the N minus 1 is constant also. And you have this P1 minus N and T to the N. This is constant also. So, based on your first law, you have Q 1 to 2, this is times the mass m, this is U2 minus U1 plus your work from 1 to 2. So your work from 1 to 2 here, this is P2 V2 minus P1 V1 over 1 minus N. Okay, and your U2 minus U1, this is CVO T2 minus T1. Okay, so that is sort of review, no, sa atong termo one, but it is applicable also here. And because this is a continuation, entropy is a continuation of our topic in our thermal one. Okay, so for the isothermal process, considering still the gas, for gases, na isothermal, we have PV equals RT, right? And this is equal to constant. And we calculate the work 1 to 2. Work from 1 to 2, this is integral of from 1 to 2. This is PdV. This is integral of 1 to 2 RT dV over V. Okay, so we have the work here from 1 to 2, that is RT ln of V2 over B1. This is your work. So your Q 1 to 2, this is M, U2 minus U1 plus work 1 to 2. So since your U is a function of temperature, okay, and this is isothermal, so its change is equals to zero. Therefore, Since you, your U is a function of temperature. Okay? So, therefore, your Q from 1 to 2 is this one. And this is equivalent to that one. Okay? For isothermal process. Okay. For isentropic process, isentropic dS is equal to 0, and this is PV to the K is constant, and you have dV to the K minus 1 is also constant. And you have this also, the equation of state, this is PVRT, and your V is RT over P. By substituting, you have P is RT over P to the K, right? This is to the K, this is constant. So you have P 1 minus K T to the K is constant. Okay. Constant. So we will determine the Q from 1 to 2. So the result here, before we proceed to the in determining the heat, we simplify now, because we have here P 1 to the K T raised to the power of K. This is C over R to the K, and this R to the K, this is constant. R to the K is constant because you have the value of your R, you have also the value of your K for isentropic, and that's why you arrive this relation here. So for isentropic process, this is assumed to be adiabatic. Meaning there is no heat transfer for. So U2 minus U1 plus work 1 to 2. And this is 0 since it is adiabatic. So work 1 to 2, this is what? Negative of U1 or U2 minus U1. So your work from 1 to 2 6 negative m CVO. This is T2 minus T1, and your S2 minus S1 is constant. Okay. Therefore, you have the torque 1 to 2. This is P2 V2 minus P1 V1. This is 1 minus K. Okay.